Today, we'll be looking at whether or not life is always carbon-based. If you're new to this channel, welcome. This is Mr. Singularity, where we explore the scientific and technological breakthroughs shaping the future as we know it. There are actually 118 known elements in the periodic table, with further potential ones to be found. But out of all these potential components, astrobiologists also consider carbon essential for life and look for evidence of it in the quest for extraterrestrial life forms. However, considering our carbon fixation, there are alternate elements that could sustain life. Everything life as we know it is carbon-based, and there's a reason scientists believe it's also the most possible candidate for alien species. Carbon is the primary ingredient of organic molecules here on Earth, and there could be no life if it weren't for carbon's special abilities. Carbon is capable of forming stable bonds with other elements, including itself. In fact, it is capable of forming more compounds than any other known chemical, with approximately 10 million carbon-based compounds found in living beings on Earth. Carbon is the building stone of sugars, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids, many of which are important to existence. If there is an aspect that it will form the foundation of existence somewhere, there are a few requirements that it must satisfy. Carbon is called the king of the elements because of its immense usefulness in the creation of substances. If alien life forms are to be based on another element, this element would have to form secure bonds with a number of different elements. Both elements have electrons orbiting their nucleus, but bonding happens as they share the electron with another element. This factor will also need to be abundant enough in the cosmos so that it is not totally out of the ordinary for it to be discovered on a random planet. In addition, it should be able to recycle itself in a manner much as carbon does in Earth's carbon cycle. Living species need a way to bring the excesses of this factor back into the system. Silicon tends to be the perfect alternative to biomass. Scientists believe this is mainly because it's really close to carbon. Carbon has four electrons in its outermost shell, and the elements appear to bind in such a way that each atom has eight electrons. This makes carbon the optimal pair-up partner, suitable for covalent bonds in which four of its own electrons share with other atoms, while four of its electrons share with it. Silicon also has four electrons, and graphene is abundant in the world, one of the top 10 most abundant elements in the universe, and 135 times more widespread on Earth than carbon. Silicon can also bind to oxygen and form long chains of its own, much as carbon does. For these factors, silicon tends to be the most possible candidate for non-carbon life. But why, then, is life not founded on silicon on our planet? Okay, amidst the similarity between silicon and carbon, silicon has certain downfalls. While silicon has four electrons, they live in its third orbital, and not the second as carbon, which effectively means that it needs more electrons to be fulfilled, thereby tending to form weaker bonds. Carbon bonds are so solid that when combined with other carbon atoms, they will become diamonds, the strongest known substance on Earth. Silicon also behaves differently when bound to oxygen, an internal part of many life forms. Oil is converted into carbon dioxide, a gas that is quickly expelled by living organisms and recycled into the atmosphere. However, silicon is made of quartz, which is solid and forms sand. Organic beings must have been hard-pressed to remove sand from their system quickly, or indeed any powerful. Yet one of the key reasons we believe life forms dependent on other elements to be impossible is that carbon-based life is what we know about it. Astrobiologists are searching for traces of carbon as a possible indicator of alien existence, since every life form we know of comes from Earth and every life form on Earth is made of carbon. Scientists can look at the reasons why this is the case, but it does not mean solutions are unlikely. When we determine the possibility of life on other planets, we look to see if they have environments close to Earth. Yet planets that are much hotter than our own will potentially give silicon a life-forming advantage, since they can survive far higher temperatures than carbon. Scientists did not believe that life could exist in such harsh environments until they found extremophiles that live in volcanic vents, like the bottom of the ocean, with temperatures of about 249 degrees Fahrenheit. Scientists had believed that planets would have liquid water and temperatures consistent with life in the so-called Goldilocks or habitable zone around their stars. But that ocean was also challenged by the discovery of possible subsurface oceans within the moon, such as Europa and Enceladus, and Titan's hydrocarbon lakes. So when contemplating new ways of life, scientists must be free-minded and creative. Some theorists have gone so far as to suggest the likelihood that dark matter is a form of alien life. Sure, non-carbon life may be very strange compared to what we're used to, but there are a lot of other components that could spawn life under the right circumstances. and we can see some examples of this on Earth. Take arsenic, for instance. Arsenic is toxic to most of life, but some aquatic algae in our own world integrate arsenic into complex organic molecules, such as arsenosugars and arseno-betaine. Other small life forms use arsenic to produce energy and lead to growth. Sulfur, too, is capable of producing very long chains of carbon-like molecules, and certain bacteria live on sulfur rather than oxygen by converting it into hydrogen sulfide. Phosphorus is also a potential substitute, since it can form long chains with itself, and when paired with nitrogen, another common factor of the universe, it can form a wide variety of possible molecules. Phosphorus is also a very important factor that is vital to life on Earth, but it may also be essential to life forms elsewhere. There is also an argument for chlorine and nitrogen. Since these theories are so new to us, there is a concern that researchers might ignore possible signs of life even though they look at them in the face. One experiment challenged participants to search for signals of Mars life. Although participants were busy examining images of terrestrial surfaces, the majority did not see a little gorilla waving in one of the photos. The goal of the experiment was to prove that humans acquire tunnel vision while they are caught up with their own prejudices and would sometimes ignore apparent signals if they are not consciously searching for them. Our carbon fixation may keep us from understanding alternate ways, so we need to be open to new possibilities. Assuming otherwise, we may very well miss them. What's your take on this? Let me know down in the comments below and check out one of these other videos. This has been Mr. Singularity, and I'll see you on the next one.